Philippine Armed Forces Remembrance Day is celebrated on January 15 every year to remember men and women who served in the nation's military over the years. The date is also used to commemorate the end of the Nigerian Civil War. The 2014 edition coincides with Nigeria's centenary celebration. On this week's edition of the program, we remember our fallen heroes. Hello there and a very warm welcome to the program and a happy new year to you. I'm Gloria Umezuke. The Nigerian Legion exists to cater for the welfare of ex-servicemen and persons who have been involved in the wars in which Nigeria participated. Now, ahead of this year's Armed Forces Remembrance Day, I spoke to the national chairman of the Nigerian Legion. There is also a special report looking at the nation's security in 2013. But first, President Goodluck Jonathan has commended the military for ensuring the proper protection of the territorial integrity of the nation. He said this at the launch of this year's Armed Forces Remembrance Emblem. Take a listen.
The men and women of our armed forces have always shown great courage and served our nation so bravely. These distinguished patriots devoted the significant part of their lives to the service of our great country and to global peace and security. And by their selfless service, many in Nigeria and abroad are today secure, strong, vital, and united. Let me at this point specially thank those who donated last year for this cause, and also those who donate this year. I also like to encourage all Nigerians to procure and wear these emblems with pride throughout the remembrance period. In fact, for those who have opportunity to have interactions with me within this period, if you don't wear it, please don't feel embarrassed because they will turn you back. It will be a requirement for all our staff and visitors to wear the emblem to gain access into all government establishments. I personally will put on the emblem from today to the end of the remembrance period, that is 15th of January next year.
Well, here is retired Colonel Micah Gaya, who joins me now on the program. Welcome to the program.
Thanks, Tom.
Well, let's begin with your organization, you know, Living in Deplorable States. That's according to many people, you know, and they're saying, how come this is happening after the Legion has served the nation judiciously? So, what really is happening?
The fact of the matter is that the Nigerian Legion is a voluntary association, self-sustaining. By implication, government is not duty-bound to get involved in the running of the Nigerian Legion. It's not duty-bound because, you know, we are a voluntary self-sustaining. But we can only be self-sustaining if government and the good people of Nigeria extend a helping hand, like this time around, when we go abroad selling our emblems, you know, to organizations. They donate generously towards the upkeep of the Nigerian Legion. So there is no way we can fare better except, you know, government directly gets involved in funding the Nigerian Legion. Compared to other nations, our veteran association is nothing to write home about, because we attend these global meetings and we know how other veteran associations compare with our own association. For example, in Britain, it is the veteran association that organizes Armed Forces Remembrance Day. And every emblem produced is paid for. And like here, when you pin somebody and he walks away, virtually every child during the 11-11 that goes to school comes back with a puppy, which he must have paid for. The parents must have made provision for it. And that is why in their public transport system, all retirees pay just half the price. In all their supermarkets, they pay just half the price. All their hospitals, they pay just half the price, which is not the case with Nigeria. So we can only fare well if we are properly funded by government.
But we have ex-servicemen who are occupying high police offices in at the moment. How are you really accessing, you know, them to help, you know, in your welfare?
Well, we keep trying to get across to our members. Don't forget that we have had military rulers here before, and it's the shared determination to help the association. Otherwise, one would have expected that during military era, air servicemen in this country would have been a lot better off.
So when you say shared determination, are you saying that they don't have such, you know, agenda for, you know, the likes of the Legion?
Well, if it was the case, we would have seen the positive effect of it.
So where is that disconnect then? Because it's supposed to be, as ex-servicemen, they're at least one of their priorities should be, you know, people like them to taking care of them and helping you guys move forward.
Well, you see, the argument has always been that ex-servicemen are only a fraction of the Nigerian populace. What we're asking for, different associations may be asking for the same. But it is not only in Nigeria that veterans are a special set of people. Very special set of people. It's not only Nigeria, but Nigerian thinking, Nigerian man thinking is that if they can do this for a service, then why not us? When we were pursuing our pension arrears, some people advanced an argument that if we pay this a service, then what about NEPA? What about teachers? What about this and that? That argument is always there. And honestly, it is not right. It is not right because ex-servicemen all over the world are a special set of people.
Do you still feel you guys have a voice anywhere?
Well, it depends on how we come together as a group of retirees. Of course, we have a voice. We have a very sizable population. We have a very, very large population.
The population?
The population of ex-servicemen here is well over 10 million with their families, with their extended families. With their families. So we have a very large population, and we can have an effect, but the question is, how do we